I want you to push today. Give it everything you got. Let's go. I like what I saw today. That was some beautiful work. All right, buddy. We're gonna time the shoot and get the takedown. Shoot and get that takedown. That was some good work in there. Again, drillers make killers. Drill, drill, drill. Why? Because repetition is the mother of all skill. That's why. Let's go. Here we go. Soften them up. Keep going. Keep working. Oh yeah, that's how champions train. Listen, you fight like that, you're gonna dominate. Guaranteed. That was nice. I like the way you drove from the hips and exploded into that takedown.
Travel the road is less chose. Battle my woes, clear foes. Stay the road. Herbie, that's what we say to those.
We say, they can't hold me down. Get in my way.
Rhymes with Martin Luther. Wrote down all my dreams and gave the world my Karma Sutra. Feel the same as Gabi. Please don't get me started. Got an international crib and a local army. Bitch, I'm built like Malcolm. Work produced the outcome. Militant, the benefits of diligence is awesome. Bitch, I made like Caesar. Trips out to Ibiza. Eating steak and lobster when we came from EBT.
And now our kill the tape for this lightweight scrap. Now to get us started, the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buff.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Vicious. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, ready to go here for round one. He won his last fight by decision. It was dominant. him. He is ready to make another UFC start. Can he get the finish tonight? A stoppage would certainly be useful as he tries to take his career to the next level.
Oh, tense moment here. That arm triangle's tight.
He may finish this fight by submission.
Oh, somehow, some way he got out.
These guys are back and forth, and submission defense wins this transition.
And right into side control.
Oh, nice. Oh, he's got to be careful there, yep.
Oh, now looking to posture up, and he lands a big head strike. Nicely done there by McGregor.
All right, so the fighter's able to reverse position on the ground, and now he's got the dominant position.
Yeah, what a great job recognizing that once he got the reversal, he went right to his offense. He didn't wait, John. He did a good job of, while his opponent goes, oh my goodness, I lost the position, he said, no, no, we're not done. I'm gonna get to a dominant position myself.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you gotta be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent.
All right, so some high-level stuff there on the ground, but as they make their way back to the feet, a huge response from the crowd, no surprise there.
I loved it. I loved all the grappling that was on display there. But fight fans want to see striking, and that's exactly what they're going to get as he finally makes his way back to his feet.
Ooh! Oh, and he lands another combination here, really starting to get into a striking group.
I mean, it's stringing them together so effectively. Never throwing the same attack more than once. What a job to recognize all the openings in his opponent's defenses.
My champ's starting to see some swelling upstairs now.
Well, he's taking way too many shots to the head. You gotta move your head. You cannot. He's hurting bad here.
Under a minute to go in what has been a wild round one. Oh, you talk about mixing the martial arts. Perfect strategy here. Continues to attack here. We'll see if he can set up the arm bar.
That is tight. He's got it locked in.
Oh, he is out. How good is that?
That is phenomenal submission defense by this young man.
All right, DC, half guard position here. You've done a lot of good work in this spot in your career.
Oh, man, I love this position. And you
going for that patented rear naked choke now. Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. So the fighter was really caught in a submission there just as the horn sounded. Safe to say he was saved by the bell there. So back to the stools they go. 60 seconds to recover here. We're going to fight. All right, so a huge round for him there. Nearly had him out of there with the head kick. Did get the knock.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Round two here. Push kick there to the body. Able to check the high kick.
Game of inches right there, boy. Wow. It was a good night that that landed.
All right, so you can see some swelling on the facial region now as his opponent lands yet another strike, and that one was clean.
I mean, this guy is so clean with his striking. He knows exactly what he wants to accomplish, and he does a great job of doing just that.
Big elbow there, lands. Oh, nicely done there as he escapes back to his feet. Outstanding placement as he lands the knee at the body. Again, the taller fighter making noise with a knee strike there. McGregor's in half guard now. Now inside the closed guard.
And he's going to try to find ways to pass and move to a submission. And now he's attempting to choke.
Oh, he's in trouble here, DC.
He's got the triangle with a lot of pressure going down on his opponent.
Need some more, guys.
That's tight. Oh, he got out!
He actually bridged, got his hips up in the air, used his momentum to take him back towards his opponent's feet, chest down to the mat to get out of that deep submission attempt.
Really good job to land these strikes from top position.
So he needs to mix it up. He needs to start kicking more. Big clinch position. Watch him start to hang. Try to gas his opponent out by hanging on his head.
his misses are entertaining. Well, he's really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive now here and starting to find himself in the pocket. Oh, McGregor's right torso starting to bruise pretty good here. Now, oh, and a quick... These are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grab.
Well, he's on his back now, going for the rear naked choke. We'll see if he can get under the chin.
Oh, he's getting it deep.
Oh, I thought he was going to go out. Instead, he escapes and reverses.
He didn't go out. He got out. Great job defensively by the fighter.
Nice sprawl there as he stuffs another takedown. So that was a big priority coming in, and the takedown defense has absolutely held up to him.
Yeah, he's done a fantastic job of understanding the threat of the takedown.
Kick there as he lands it. Maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got hurt very bad.
So there's the horn. The round is over. He stunned his opponent multiple times in that round. A huge round from McGregor. All right, let us now look back at some of the highlights from that round. And there just aren't that many guys on this roster that can keep up this offensive wrestling pace over 15 or 25 minutes.
But he's one of those guys. He is one of those guys that's able to continuously take you down even if you get up over and over. He has this ability to maintain that pace and pressure that he can wear his opponents down. That's why you see him get so many finishes as the fight progresses. And he has a great double leg. My goodness, he has a great double leg.
All right, so he just decides to get up here and let the opponent up.
He blocked that punch.
Oh! Huge kick to the head. Well, just as he did the previous round, continuing to land a high number of strikes here, and he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down. Scary, scary proposition for the opponent. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. Lands a big elbow there. McGregor's bleeding from the mouth, Daniel. Looks as though there's a cut on his lip. Thankfully, he's a lot tougher than I am.
Another big takedown. In the half guard. Oh, he's going triangle here.
Oh, that arm triangle's wicked tight.
He's starting to get it in very deep.
Oh, that's got to be it. Oh, he's trying to buck the hips. Looked like he got the hand ready to tap.
I mean, look at that. What a beautiful display of submission defense. Not panicking in a position that is very, very difficult to deal with.
All right, working inside his opponent's guard here.
You cannot sit in these jiu-jitsu guys' guard. And you keep...
Oh, he's going triangle again.
Oh, my goodness, he's getting it tight.
That is
going to do it! Oh, my goodness!
How about it? So what a win for him here tonight. He gets it done and gets it done by way of submission. He told us this week, I got to keep these judges out of it. Mission accomplished.
Absolutely. He is a phenomenal grappler. He said that he held the advantage there and that would show itself in the fight. He proved that and he gets a submission victory. Amazing.
All right, let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
I mean, you know, this guy has such a great submission game that you cannot lay in his guard. He's so skilled, he's so tricky, and he's so good at weaving a web that gets you lost in it, that he made him pay for it tonight and got the submission victory.
All right, here now, Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 2:53 of round number 3, declaring the winner by submission due to an arm triangle choke, the notorious Conor McGregor!
Well, what an incredible result here tonight as you see the winner there celebrating his victory by way of submission.